Chakras for Beginners, Healing and Balancing Your Chakras the Right Way, written by Stephanie White, narrated by Kip Ferguson. Introduction. According to ancient traditions of many cultures and faiths, there is a universal vital energy that can be found in all living beings. The Chinese referred to this energy as qi, whilst in India it is known as prana, and in the Japanese culture it's called ki. Today, this energy is called by many names, from life force energy and bioenergy to primal energy and many more names. This energy is very subtle, and modern science is only just touching on being able to measure it, yet it can definitely be perceived, and its manipulation is a key factor in energy healing to which our bodies respond really well. There are several energy points where this energy appears to be concentrated and enters and leaves our bodies. These points are in the form of vortexes and are known as chakras. There are 7 main chakra points and several other minor ones as well. The energy flows through these vortexes with a spinning motion, which is what gives them the name chakra, which in ancient Sanskrit means wheel or that which spins or rotates. The 7 main chakra points are located at set points physically in our bodies or in our subtle energy bodies or aura. These points can benefit in being maintained in order to allow the energy to keep on flowing and for us to remain balanced both physically and mentally. Each of the chakras has its own vibration and will respond to external stimulus in the form of sympathetic vibrations by opening and spinning faster with more ease. The external vibrations that will stimulate a chakra effectively are principally colors and sounds. The vibration of the chakra itself is very high, but as each color has its own wavelength and frequency, and each of the 7 colors of the rainbow coincides with the lower harmonics of each of the chakras, musical notes are also able to stimulate the chakras, with a note being once again a lower harmonic of the vibration of the chakra itself. In essence, each chakra will respond to a certain color or musical note. Also, they will respond to other subtle vibrations, like the natural vibration of quartz crystals or other gemstones. Each chakra, therefore, has its own associated gemstone that can stimulate it and help to activate it. When we have one or more of our chakras blocked, or better said, not spinning at the speed they should be, then our bodies and minds will also be blocked, and it can be the root of many other apparently non-related physical and mental conditions. A trained energy healer or therapist will be able to balance your chakras in a moment, and this will aid the body on its road to healing itself. You can also open and balance your chakras by means of simple meditation exercises. Here is a very short overview of each of the chakras with its corresponding color and aspects. The first chakra, root, red, related to survival and primal energy. Second chakra, sacral, orange, related to joy and life. Third chakra, solar plexus, yellow, associated with your personal power. Fourth chakra, heart, green or pink, love and issues of the heart. The fifth chakra, throat, blue or turquoise, associated with self-expression and communication. Sixth chakra, third eye, indigo, clairvoyance, foresight, insight, and self-realization. Seventh chakra, crown, violet, white, or golden, related totally to your spiritual connection. Meditation self-help using chakra-guided visualizations can have a positive effect on your health. Guiding your visualization skills requires great concentration, and this can be difficult to achieve on a conscious level. You can peel away the skins of distraction by using your subconscious to focus on the chakras. When you use the power of your mind to visualize each of the 7 components, you are able to recognize the connections between your mind, body, and spirit. They all interact together. When you're not open and aware of these important relationships, you can feel it in your physical self. The disharmony between your mind, emotion, and body can cause physical distress and illness. Once you become accustomed to visualizing each component, you can overcome physical difficulties and help heal some health problems in conjunction with medical interventions. The images you create in your mind guide you through your body, combining thought and emotion to foster better health and inner harmony.
this approach has significant effects on your physical self. Physical realm. The physical realm is often disassociated from the cognitive mind. Many people fail to recognize that the mind and the body are interconnected. Spiritually, cognition, and emotion are all part of who you are. These components are manifested in your physical body. For example, you could have physical difficulties in the gallbladder, stomach, kidneys, spleen, liver, or the diaphragm when your solar plexus is closed. The health problems can be addressed through meditative exercises and visualizing the affected area of the body. This approach is complementary to any medical interventions deemed necessary by your physician. As you open your chakras, you open the path to healing. This has great benefits in your emotional realm. The solar plexus also has connections to the emotional elements in your life pertaining to self-esteem and confidence. Self-hypnosis and visualization. When you use your visualization power in conjunction with self-hypnosis, you can reach a higher plane. You are not relying on your conscious mind as a guide. The subconscious is engaged and it serves as a natural guide through your meditative processes. Your body responds on many levels to this form of meditation. You have access to your thoughts, emotions, and physical components through the images you create in your mind. Chakra-guided visualization is a wonderful approach to developing a healthy mind, spirit, and body. Pollution of the five elements. Everything in this universe is made of five elements: earth, water, air, fire, and space. These five elements are also present in the human body. If these elements are polluted in the external world, they are also contaminated in the human body, because that which is outside is also inside. However, it needs to be mentioned that of the five elements, space and fire cannot get contaminated because of their very nature. The nature of fire is to burn everything it comes into contact with, to ashes, to its base element. It has no discrimination. It consumes and devours everything it touches. Space is infinite and holds everything within it, and yet is not touched by anything. Nothing exists without space. It cannot be stained. It cannot be contaminated. So we are left only with the other three elements, earth, water, and air, that can be polluted. What is the root cause of these elements is what the Upanishad rishis questioned. Can they exist by themselves? Do they have a consciousness that can say, "I exist"? Who says they exist? I say they exist. Who is this I? This I is an entity that is aware of its own existence and everything around it. The final question put forth by the Upanishad rishis was, what is the root cause of this I? Who is to say this I exists? And they came to the irrefutable conclusion that this I is the causeless cause of everything that exists. It needs no proof of its own existence and gives proof to the existence of everything else by its awareness. Therefore, this I is consciousness that is existence and awareness, what is termed in Santana Dharma as sat and sheet.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.